Is the RBI concerned about the fact that that could crowd out private borrowers? Also, since there's so much borrowing from the National Small Savings Fund, there is an adverse incentive to keep small saving rates high, which will then again impede transmission. Isn't that a big hindrance to transmission right now as well?
You see, the government has broadly followed the fiscal glide path over the last 5 years. Broadly, the fiscal glide path has been followed. I think in 14-15, the fiscal deficit was about the budgeted number in the interim budget was about 4.5%. Then it was budgeted little lower, and I think they ended the year in 14-15 at 4.1%. Then it was 3.5, if I recollect correctly. Then it has now come down to 3.4. So broadly, they have followed the fiscal glide path. And so far as the borrowings by the public sector companies and the crowding out effect, the total borrowing requirement of the public sector companies will have to be seen in, you know, from the perspective of 2 points. One is there are certain public sector entities like the NTPC or the, for example, the NTPC or the NHAI, which undertake a lot of capital expenditure and which have their own revenue streams to repay their borrowings. So therefore, it's better to look at that borrowing as a part of the capital investment requirements of the economy rather than seeing them as a borrowing by the government. No, these borrowings are supported by borrowings which are supported by revenue streams of public sector companies themselves, not depending on the budget for repayment, but they have their own revenue streams, like the National Highway Authority or the National Thermal Power Corporation, and similar. Let me just come back, please. So I didn't mention PFC. I said public sector entities which have their own revenue streams to repay those borrowings, they have to be taken together as a part of the overall, you know, borrowing by the, you know, by the, what you call the industrial or the commercial sector of the economy. So far as the other sectors are concerned, the fiscal deficit numbers, the government, as I said, has broadly maintained the fiscal deficit glide path. And we do expect the government also to remain fiscally prudent, broadly fiscally prudent. As regards the other issues of small savings, etc., I am sure government will take note of the overall economic, you know, the developments and take whatever decision is considered necessary.
Thank you.